Hey and welcome, I'm Hammeh, and in this new series I'll be looking at different concepts of the science of Overwatch, what we know lore-wise in-game about them, of course, any real-life grounding they might have in our world today, and a little speculation finally as to how they might work in the Overwatch universe. In this episode, I'm delving into medical technology in Overwatch, specifically nanobiology and biotics. These are fairly key to the story in several ways, entwined with Mercy, Ana, and Soldier 76, amongst others, and healing and damage boosting tech in the game, so it's an interesting topic to try and understand more about. I'm no scientist, but trying my best, so if you are an expert, please sound off in the comments below. Okay, here we go. Firstly, let's have a look at how medical technology, specifically nanobiology, exists in the Overwatch universe currently. We can see three or four main applications of the applied nanobiology, I think, that is cited as Mercy's specialism in her profile. The first of these is healing. Mercy's healing with her Caduceus staff, Ana's biotic rifle and biotic bomb healing, and Soldier 76's biotic field all are healing examples we see in-game, with one of them also shown out of game in the canon lore. There's also damaging secondarily, a poison-like effect with Ana's dual-purpose biotic rifle rounds and also her biotic bomb that shows the potential for nanobiological technology to do damage as well. Thirdly, we also see healing denial or prevention of healing or other healing technologies working with Ana's biotic bomb too. And finally, there's a boosting or augmentation enhancing effect, Mercy's damage enhancing beam and Ana's nano boost, increasing damage, speed and even reducing damage taken in the case of Ana's ability. Outside of those four main applications, there's a few related pieces of technology in terms of targeting and delivery of these medical solutions that I find pretty interesting. Ana's rounds, for example, which have different effects on friend and foe, and Mercy's beam that has this kind of lock-on effect. To quickly go through the elephant in the room before we proceed, I'm leaving Mercy's resurrection ability out of this for now. It has no canon or lore source pointing to it outside of the game, and it may not be a literal transfer into the actual canon story. So I wouldn't assume at the moment that Mercy can bring people back from the dead in the canon lore of Overwatch, unless we're told otherwise. But it's up in the air for now. Time to now explore the basis of what the science is and could be in our present day real world before moving on to how it could work in Overwatch. Advances are already being made in nanotechnology and nanobiology, whether it's advances in processing technology in the electronics world or tailored medicines and gene therapy in the nanobiological field. It is pretty complicated, but a lot of people's confusion, including mine initially, stems around the uses of terminology. But the terms can have slightly different meanings, and understanding these can aid our understanding of potentially how Mercy's and Overwatch's tech work. A lot of people, including myself, confused nanobiotics or biology with nanorobotics and machinery, so I'll quickly explain where this tech is today. Nanomachines, son! It is now a bit of a trope, often used as a plot device in a lot of sci-fi. We've seen it from Metal Gear Solid's infamous memery to Deus Ex, Star Trek, and many other places in TV, film, and gaming storytelling. People tend to focus on the miniaturized robot idea of nanomachines, thinking of literally tiny robots, like constructed spiders at a tiny scale. Stepping away from the nanomachine stereotype, Mercy's technology field is actually nanobiology, looking at more organic, biological, or synthetic miniaturized versions of tech. When we think of this as particles or biological machines rather than machinery or robots in a conventional sense, there's actually a lot more background we can potentially explore as to how the technology works. People are already developing nanobots in these forms, or to be more accurate, nanotechnology. One project under development this year in Texas in the US is creating a nanobiological treatment that could be effectively steered through our bloodstreams to unblock any blockages in hearts or blood vessels. These bots, if we can call them those, are specifically designed particles which are magnetized, meaning they can be steered or guided with electromagnets. Although there's a certain degree of PR involved in dubbing anything a nanobot in 2016 to get attention, funding and similar, the term's kind of debated among scientists. These are apparently being tested in mice soon, which could lead to human testing in just 4 years' time. Now obviously the main challenge is control. At the moment, MRI machines, used in many scans in medical diagnosis, operate with huge magnets, and there's a reason that you're not meant to have any metal or objects on or within you when you go into those. They can effectively be ripped out. Nasty. Another form of existing nanobiotics in testing are DNA bots that are folded packages of DNA. Inside the package is a drug, say to destroy a particular type of cancer or harmful cell. The package has a lock on the outside that can only be opened by a key that exists on the outside of the cancer cell when the two come into contact. That's enzymes and substrates for you school biology students, or if like me, you studied it quite a long time ago. These kind of treatments mean that the treatment can be delivered very specifically to a target area where it's needed, rather than something less targeted, say, like chemotherapy. With targeted nano-treatments such as this already in the making on a more basic level than Overwatch's tech, although don't get me wrong, it's still amazing, we can now take a look at Overwatch's technology with this knowledge in mind. let's have a look in a bit more depth about what we know about nanobiology in the Overwatch world, and then theorise a bit on how it could potentially work with our new real-life knowledge. Firstly, how much time have we got for tech to further itself? Overwatch has been cited in numerous interviews as being roughly 60 years in the future. That dates the Overwatch first Omnic crisis as roughly 30 years in the future or so. So in 60 years' time in the near future, medical advances in Overwatch have come a long way in both improving and repairing the human body. Bearing in mind in the 1950s, 60 years ago from today, we were developing various vaccines and we hadn't sequenced the human genome, there's plenty of time theoretically for technology to advance. As I mentioned before, we see the four main applications of applied nanobiology in Overwatch: healing, damaging, prevention of healing or other healing tech, and this boosting effect. We'll explore each of these with examples in universe, along with speculation based on our real-life discoveries. Warning, from now on it's pretty theoretical and all speculation based. I'll shout when things are law, anything else assume that it's speculating off the back of what we know. In theorising about nanobiology in Overwatch, a great place to start is with Ana's rifle and with one very useful image we've been given. In this image, which was released to help tease Ana's introduction as a hero, we can actually see what looks like most of the biotic healing tech. In it, we can see Torbjorn proposing a new design for a biotic rifle, using elements of technology already present in Mercy's Caduceus stuff. We can also see something that looks like Soldier 76's biotic emitter, and also Ana's biotic bomb and potential darts as well. Now, interestingly, Mercy did express concerns in this internal Overwatch memo that this design could actually lead on a slippery slope towards her tech being weaponized. Her fears clearly came true. Whatever happened since these schematics, whether it was an official Overwatch development or not, we can now see the weaponization of biotic tech in Ana's darts and grenade. We don't actually know for sure whether Ana's current version of the weapon, with damaging elements, ended up being used in Overwatch or not while Overwatch still existed. This reminds us, of course, that any healing arts or advances in medical science can potentially be two sides of the same coin, and that there can be a negative side as well. How does Ana's rifle, and what we've learnt about nanobiology in the current day, help us theorise around how biotics work in Overwatch? In the SDCC panel on Ana's origins, we learned that Ana's allies can be inoculated, in a way, against the nanotechnology with an anti-venom type substance, so that a dart round from Ana will only give positive effects to allies shot in the field, and still be able to do the negative effects to enemies. If Ana hasn't had time or she's in a situation apparently where her team isn't inoculated, then she can switch between rounds, as we see in this panel from Old Soldiers, where she opens up on Reaper before shooting a healing round into Morrison to heal the damage she's suffered from Reaper's shotgun. This really helps us with speculating about how the nanotech is targeted. For any treatment, you need a delivery mechanism. And we can hazard a guess that Ana's darts pretty much inject people with whatever nanotechnology, particle or biological creation that's been created. The inoculation that Ana's allies apparently receive means that you can have one nanobiological solution, and this can be adapted easily for good, or, as eventually was the case, for ill. If Ana's dart rounds can hurt or heal an enemy, the inoculation injection that her allies receive could prevent any negative effects of nanobiotics delivered, but leave her enemies open to receiving those effects unless they had access to the same inoculation. There are plenty of ways this could potentially be achieved. DNA or genetic markers in the antivenom could prevent whatever's harmful in the nanobiotic from harming friendly targets, and this, of course, only means that the healing particles or active ingredient will work. Mercy's Caduceus staff is another delivery mechanism, and particularly interesting in that it locks onto friendly targets for healing or damage, but has no effect on enemies whatsoever, and actually projects the assumed nanobiotics across quite a considerable distance through the air, so that's aerosol dispersal. Potentially a similar mechanism? Well, some kind of biological targeting, specific DNA required for the beam to work, or other marker, like the inoculation for Ana's rifle, could certainly work. Alternatively, maybe Overwatch agents are fitted with some kind of device that means the beam can only lock onto allied targets. It's an interesting one to ponder. In terms of the projection through the air of any biotic healing technology, that's a pretty challenging one scientifically. Any nanobiotic solution, if it has to be ingested into the body to be effective, has to cross from the staff, through the air, survive that journey, and get into the body somehow. Whatever tiny particles or creations the healing or damage boosting consists of, they'll need a very strong outer packaging to protect the contents. However, they still need to be apparently under 500 Daltons or 500 protons in molecular weight. So that's pretty tiny to actually be able to permeate through our skin. Remember though, we have the packaging that could work inside the body in some forms right now, and we also have the targeting too. So really, it's the robustness of these particles and the way in which they're delivered through the air that the brilliant minds in the Overwatch universe have potentially managed to work out. Some of this certainly has roots in real life right now. Finally, in terms of delivery, we've got Soldier 76's biotic field. Now, as a pure healing application, this faces similar challenges to Mercy's staff. We do see him place a biotic emitter on the ground. This delivery thing's an interesting question. Maybe it's one for another video or time. It's a bit more physics, I think. Now we've sorted out the delivery of these, let's have a look at healing to start with. In terms of healing, we've got Ana's darts and Mercy's beam. as well as Soldier 76's biotic field. But actually in the lore, we've only seen one live example. That's Ana shooting Soldier 76 in Old Soldiers. Soldier 76 is able to fight on pretty effectively here after taking what looks like a glancing shotgun shot to the back or arm from Reaper. He says that the pain is gone apparently, but that doesn't mean of course that his wounds have magically healed up. Mercy's healing beam, well, we've not seen that in out-of-game story, canon as it were, yet. But if we assume the tech is similar to that of Ana's biotic rifle, as it was based on Mercy's staff, perhaps it heals in a similar nanobiological manner. In Mercy's bio, we can see that her applied nanobiology expertise could radically improve the treatment of life-threatening illnesses and injuries. Now that doesn't mention anything about regenerating tissue or instant healing, but perhaps some form of stabilization here could be the key, like a temporary wound closure. There could also be some kind of painkilling involved, like Soldier 76 mentions in Old Soldiers. This could all mean that someone targeted with the biotics could continue to function and fight for a time before getting more in-depth medical treatment. Now, as we've seen from our real-life examples, some of this is already possible. Targeted nanobiological treatments are already being worked on, and along with controversial in places research into stem cells, the ability to regenerate and regrow organs and tissues is already being researched and happening in different places in the world. However, again, as with the delivery, the challenge here is the speed in which it happens. Healing, if we look at it in game, happens in a pretty quick sense. And in Old Soldiers, Soldier 76 has a pretty quick effect. So, have Overwatch scientists somehow managed to make this technology work even more quickly than it does today? To summarise, healing nanobiology, we can speculate, could well be a targeted delivery of biotic or biological particles, like stem cells or DNA packages, or something a bit more technological, but in a basic sense, or nanobots in a more real-life context, perhaps chains of particles, with some kind of targeting built in at a biological level to repair or stabilise certain kinds of damaged tissue. In terms of targeting, there's certainly some kind of factor built in that mean that they can only act on certain people due to a certain marker. Whether that's genetic or otherwise, we just don't know. Next up, let's take a look at the damaging properties of nanobiology in Overwatch. We have Ana's rounds, which do a damage over time effect, and Ana's grenade, which is a bomb, kind of does flat damage. Given what we've learned about real-life nanobiology, and from what we've speculated on healing in Overwatch, there's plenty of reasonable explanations for the damaging properties of this biotic tech. Exactly how it damages people is something we've not seen yet, but as many kinds of poisoning sadly exist in the world today, it's not a stretch to see it as a more evolved form of poisoning. The damage over time effect of Ana's rifle is certainly poison-like, and if it's some kind of mixed biotic solution, then I'm sure that nanotechnology could be created with that in mind. As for the biotic bomb damage, there's plenty of ways that nanobiology could improve on an on-contact damaging solution, very sadly. And sometimes weapons research and medical research are two different sides of the same coin. What's more interesting about Ana's biotic bomb that I just mentioned, leading into our third point, is our third application of nanobiotics, how it can actually deny healing from other sources. If there are common biotic healing agents on the market in Overwatch, and again, we don't know that Overwatch exclusively had this technology, or Mercy was indeed the only one to work on such things, then perhaps Ana's biotic bomb has something active in it which prevents other nanobiotic healing solutions from taking hold or working. If nanobiotic healing goes through the skin, then this could cover the skin, stopping them from being ingested and taking effect. Or perhaps something more advanced even, that targets other nanobiotic healing directly. Again, as with the DART anti-venom, the nanobiotic technology could be created to not affect those who have been marked or inoculated. And this would explain, like with the darts, how Ana can throw a grenade into a group of friendlies and enemies and get different effects on each group in-game. Lastly, out of our four different fields, I find it really interesting in terms of the boost. This increase of someone's combat performance and proficiency for a short period of time. We've got two examples, both Ana's nano boost and Mercy's damage boosting beam, although whether they're the same nanobiological tech, we don't quite know. They do share a colour though, both are sort of represented with a blue field around Ana's nano boost target and the blue beam by Mercy's Caduceus stuff. We could look at a damage boost as an increased alertness, awareness and endurance ability, and perhaps people reacting more quickly in combat, all of those known factors resulting in this dealing of more damage. If you couple that with a movement speed increase of Ana's boost, then one type of boost we have here could easily be a nanobiological version of some kind of stimulants, adrenaline-like if you will. I actually like the example of this existing chemically in a totally different Blizzard universe, StarCraft. Certain Terran foot soldiers have the ability to use inbuilt chemical delivery systems in their suits, which douse the Marines with a powerful mix of synthetic adrenaline, endorphins, and, worryingly, a psychotropic aggression enhancer. Pretty strong stuff. In-game, that results in them firing faster and moving more quickly. Now, StarCraft's a far distant and, of course, totally different sci-fi future, of course, than Overwatch. Totally different universe. But that example is a nice example of chemicals actually achieving something similar. So how could a nanobiotic solution differ? Hormones like adrenaline can cause side effects like shakiness, anxiety, and sweating, and stimulants have a bunch of side effects as well. An obvious benefit of a more engineered biological solution would be to remove these side effects or any downer as the body recovers, therefore allowing for safer and more repeated use. The more interesting or less easily explicable thing about this nanobiotic field augmentation is the damage reduction that Ana's boost also provides. As this is delivered by a dart, remember, we're assuming a different nanobiotic formula or agent to the healing or hurting formula of the damaging darts and the biotic bomb grenade. This perhaps is why Mercy also has her two colours of beam. There's definitely blue colour for Mercy's beam and Ana's boost that seem to be kind of shared. Alongside the stimulant effects, perhaps this formula also contains some kind of cell fortification shielding or creates some kind of barrier there with the skin. At the moment, we're currently only able to reduce pain felt with preemptive painkiller usage in our world today. But anything actively preventing the body from taking its usual damage is certainly technology beyond our time. It all depends on how literally, of course, we take the in-game abilities as being present in Overwatch lore or canon. As I mentioned, I don't think the Mercy resurrection will be a true from the dead type technology, but who knows? With all of these uses of medical tech, let's have one final thought. What happens if competing nanotechnologies or medical technologies go awry or clash? With the world of Overwatch yet to be fully revealed or fully explored in some forms of lore, we shouldn't forget a quote from Arthur C. Clarke, a noted science fiction author and theorist, compatriot to Isaac Asimov if you've ever read him. Clarke himself wrote short stories that had some of the ideas of nanotechnology in some 60 years ago in 1956. One of his three laws or adages can certainly come into play in Overwatch. Any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. I think this may have been quoted by Overwatch devs in an interview, I need to go and check the source, but when we look to things like the current state that Reaper exists in, we should think always of science first. Whether nanotechnology is or isn't involved with Reaper, or indeed a lot of the other situations in Overwatch, its world of science is sufficiently advanced beyond our own that we possibly couldn't even understand it. It'll be fascinating to discover what technologies exist in more detail and how they work in future. Phew! Thanks for watching this mixture of lore, game theory, and science in Overwatch. This kind of video is a bit new for me. Please let me know what you thought, how I can improve it in the comments below, and do subscribe, like, and share it with people if you enjoyed it. What's your theory about healing and nanobiological tech in Overwatch? I'd love to hear all about it. My regular lore videos are all coming this week, including hero lore and interactions. It is coming, I promise this time. Lore bites, and more still, so don't go away now. Cheers for tuning in. I'm Hammeh. Take it easy.